have discussed is, suppose if your vectors are not coplanar, then how will you add the vectors? One law of addition we have already tried, that is the triangular law of vector addition. So today what we'll be doing, the next law of addition, that is the parallelogram law of vector addition. So this is your parallelogram. So how to use the parallelogram law of vector addition, and why the parallelogram law of vector addition is used and not the other laws of addition? Parallelogram law of vector addition is mainly used when your vectors are co-initial vectors. Remember that. If your vectors are co-initial vectors, then we have to use the parallelogram law of vector addition. Okay, so the parallelogram law of vector addition states that if the two sides of the parallelogram are represented by the two vectors resultant, that is the total of the vector, the two vectors that you have taken, will be represented by its diagonal. That means this will be your diagonal. So let us prove it. What will be the formula for the resultant? Let us see.
As you have seen in the video, I have discussed about the parallelogram law of vector addition. So I have also told you in the last class that I will be calculating the angle formed by the resultant with the different vectors. That angle, if you see in the diagram also, that was given as an angle alpha. That angle I will be calculating. So suppose for the triangular law, I am doing for first triangular law of vector addition. So our diagram was in this way. This was our vector A, this was our vector B. Okay, or sorry, I think this was, I think I have given vector B and this is vector A. If according to my diagram, this can be written as A also, okay, if you want to write. Then the resultant will be represented by its diagonal. This we have taken as angle alpha, and we have also extended this line as this angle will be theta. So after this, what I have to do, I have to calculate the angle. So if I calculate the angle, then we have to use tan alpha. So tan alpha is equals to perpendicular by base. So here you can see the perpendicular, this is your angle. So this will be a hypotenuse, this will be your base, and this will be your perpendicular. Clear? So perpendicular by base, I think you just see the diagram, I forgot what I have done, the notation I have done. You compare with your diagram. I am using this as O, this as P, Q, and S. Okay, so if I use it, so this will be PS divided by OS. So PS divided by OQ plus QS. Clear? So this PQS and PS we have already calculated. Like suppose, again I am repeating, sine theta will be equal to perpendicular by hypotenuse. So perpendicular was PS, hypotenuse was this PQ. So PS will be equal to PQ sine theta. And what is PQ? PQ is nothing but A. So it is A sine theta. In place of PQ, or sorry, PS, I'll be using A sine theta. So this will be A sine theta divided by OQ is your B, plus in place of QS, it will be your A cos theta. Yeah, so this is the formula for the angle calculating the triangular law of vector addition. The same way, if I go for the parallelogram law of vector addition, let us try that one also. So this is our parallelogram. So this parallelogram law of vector addition I have already done in the last class. So if I calculate the angle from this parallelogram law of vector addition, again we have to use tan alpha is equals to perpendicular by base. So it will be QT divided by, it will be OT. Again, QT divided by, it will be OS plus ST. So again, it will be, what will be QT then? QT, if I calculate, this will be your QS sin theta. QS sin theta divided by OS will be, this will be your vector B plus, this will be QS cos theta. PO and QS, since these are parallelogram, so the opposite sides will be equal. So this will also be vector A. So this will be vector A sin theta divided by vector B plus A cos theta. So this is the formula for the angle calculating for the parallelogram law of vector addition. So in the next class, we'll be discussing some more topics related with the vectors, like addition we have already done. We'll be go for the multiplication in the next class. Thank you.